Representative George Santos apparently told the House GOP conference on Tuesday behind closed doors that he wants off the two committees that he's currently on until his issues are resolved. And I think what he means by that is people stop asking him questions. I'm assuming at this point that his issues will never truly be resolved. They seem baked quite deep into him. But anyway, as of right now, he's serving on the small business and the science committees, and he apparently doesn't want to do that for now. Representative Marjorie Taylor Greene of Georgia told CNN that it was Santos's decision that he made on his own to abstain from the committees. I've literally never heard of anyone doing this before, but she said he told the conference he would step aside from the committees as the GOP is trying to oust Democratic Representative Ilhan Omar of Minnesota from the Foreign Affairs Committee. She said specifically, he just felt like there was so much drama really over the situation, and especially what we're doing to remove Ilhan Omar from the Foreign Affairs Committee. But Mr. Santos' statement in there was just saying that he spoke with Speaker McCarthy and made this decision on his own. So I think tying this, for whatever reason, to their ridiculous xenophobic, Islamophobic attempt to get Ilhan Omar off of her committee is weird. They really do want to stress that this was his decision and not Kevin McCarthy's, which that actually makes me like maybe think that Kevin McCarthy did push for it. Why are they being so explicit about that? One would think a decision that a congressman announces was his decision. It seems defensive, like it's like they don't want the MAGA people to know that Kevin McCarthy was pushing for one of the big liars in their party off. I don't know. I'm a little bit confused, Elise, but what do you think?
I mean, don't you know George Santos is against the drama? You know, he wants to back away from it all. Or of course, he wants to just avoid anything. I honestly couldn't tell you, but this is the first time hearing about it. But I think you're right. It is just a way to distance Kevin McCarthy from any decision making, which is, it just seems like something he wouldn't necessarily want. I don't think he likes that he's being perceived as this spineless figure, but more and more decisions that are coming out of the House don't seem to associate with him. And this is just another example.
Yeah. There's a lot that I am fully willing to admit that I don't understand about this and that I'm not sure about. But if I can say definitively, I do not buy that he doesn't like drama. Come on, this guy. Didn't he, when like his boyfriend was going to leave him, he was like, oh, I bought us tickets for a big vacation down to South America. And it was totally made up. He didn't have the tickets or whatever. Like, come on. Then he stole the guy's phone. You love the drama. And that's fine. Lots of people do. That might be the most endearing thing about George Santos. But no, I think, look, if anything, this is Kevin McCarthy wanting to not have another interview like he had with Margaret Brennan, which I understand. It was brutal. Him wanting to recede from the spotlight a little bit, thinking maybe that gets people to move on and forget about me. Or number three, the dude doesn't really want to work. He doesn't want to work on like marking up legislation and coming up with amendments and late night voteramas and all that. He wants like the benefits and he wants the cred without the work. So I don't know. I think he might just be using this as an opportunity to get out of some homework.
Yeah, no, I agree. He's a drama politician. He's an attention grabbing person. And this is another headline that he gets to make. And it has nothing to do with policy again. So
yeah,
whether it's Kevin McCarthy or George Santos or some combination of the two.
For more political news breakdowns, interviews, stories of activism, and me trying my hardest to care about the occasional big celebrity news story, subscribe to our YouTube channel at youtube.com/thedamagereport. And you can ring the bell wherever it is so you don't miss anything.